Have any of you noticed a familiar pattern in some of these things? Somatomimizing is here in the place, but essentially, it's something that has the nasal block set and is produced by this mathematical function. And here we are. And that's the Mandelbrot set right above it. And simply, how about you start off with C equal to any number, and start off with Z equal to 0. You get the result, you plug the result back into the function, and you do that over and over and over again. Now, depending on the number you pick for C, you'll either get a very, very large number, or you won't. So essentially, the Mandelbrot set is a number line of where the numbers get bigger and bigger, and where they go. And the region between these two objects is very, very beautiful. Now, the region between the head and the body, is something known as the C-horse valley. Now, as we zoom in, maybe you can see why. On the left there, we have a pattern known as a double spiral. On the right, we have a pattern known as a C-horse. Now, you can imagine an upside-down C-horse. There you have it. You can see that the same C-horse shape just repeats on and on. It just gets smaller and smaller. One of the more interesting things about the Mandelbrot set is you see these same few figures repeating on and on and on into infinity. They just get smaller and smaller and smaller. Now, as we zoom in here in the center of this slide, maybe you can even notice that we even have a miniature version of the original Mandelbrot set shape that we started out with. Upon further inspection, you'll see that it is indeed the same shape. Now, as we look through these next couple of fractals, keep in mind, recurring shapes as well. Getting ready for our first fractal in 3. folks, there are some fractals that may be a little more familiar to our eyes. We're going to use one first identified by a British mathematician named Michael Barnsley. Following our infinite triangle, we're going to use a slightly different set of rules here. You can see that this forms a fern leaf. It turns out that nature is actually full of fractals. So let's see what else we can find. Shapes form a tree. Fractal patterns in nature can be found all over our planet, and they do get a lot bigger. Next up, we're going to look at a river network in China. Now, thanks to millions of years of rainfall and erosion, we can find fractal river networks transporting water from the land to the oceans, with its rivers branching off into rivers and streams. Much like the circulatory system in the body, fractal river networks can be found all over Earth, transporting water from the land to the oceans, but we can find them elsewhere out in the cosmos. Next up, we're going to take a look at spiral galaxies. Thanks to gravity and billions of years of motion, one of the most common type of galaxy in the known universe is the spiral galaxy. Right now we're looking at the Milky Way galaxy, which is the galaxy we live in. It's a barred spiral galaxy. There's big barred, moon, spiral arms stretch out past. Another spiral galaxy you can see in the night sky is the Andromeda galaxy, which is the most distant object that can be seen with the naked eye. You don't need telescopes or binoculars to look at the Andromeda galaxy. You just need to know where to look and have a very, very dark sky. Now, bringing our attention back to planet Earth, but still keeping our mind on spirals, maybe you can think of the spiral pattern of the clouds within our own atmosphere. Of course, guys, I'm talking about a hurricane. A hurricane is a self-organizing spiral that forms from clouds and forms from tropical storms near the waters of the equator. Right now we're looking at a picture of Hurricane Irma. Next up, still keeping our minds on spirals, but at least slightly smaller and maybe tastier variety. What you're looking at is a picture of Romanesco broccoli, which is an actual vegetable that you can buy at the grocery store. And each of its buds are a series of smaller buds, which have spirals, and even smaller spirals. I'm seeing these wonderful fractal patterns both on Earth and humans. Hopefully this just gives you a greater appreciation for some of the beauty that can be created through them.
Now.
the floor. Fantastic. Crackles. We're going to turn up the lights and open the back exit.